Hi, Susan. I'm very glad to talk with you before screening of your film, The Way of the Psychonaut.
Oh, thank you so much, Vladimir. It's my pleasure to be here.
Yeah, it's a great privilege for us to be first official watchers of your film that was awarded on recent festival in Venice, I know. And has great success in the world. And I want to ask you how you approach to the idea to make this film. What is your background as film director and as a spiritual person?
Well, my spiritual journey actually began, I will be 63 July 10th, but when I was 25 years old, I was an actress. And I was very determined to get a role in a big movie. And so I had to use techniques that were introduced actually by a Bhagwan, Sri, I'm trying to remember his name now, Rajneesh actually had taught these various techniques to my acting teacher. And so we learn these techniques for going deep, inner exploration. And I'm sitting on a set in the middle of what they call a screen test, desperately trying to access this deep truth so that I could bring it forth in the scene. And I felt as though I dropped into a huge dark pit and there was nothing in there. And I remember thinking, my life is a lie. And I barely got through the screen test, but that began a deep inner journey to try to understand who I was, what am I doing here? What did I come here to do? And it began over 30 years of spiritual exploration. And so whether it's a Vipassana retreat with Goenkaji for 11 days of not speaking, or learning shamanic journey work, or recently learning holotropic breath work, and having these deep experiences that connected me to a dimension of spirit. And then when I had this very powerful, deep, experiential, spiritual life, and I wanted to have children. And I was in my late 30s, and the clock was ticking, so to speak. And I was told by someone during a spiritual weekend in France, where I had met my husband, who is French. And she told me that I was not connected to the earth, and that in order to have children, I needed to shift my consciousness to this plane. And so I stopped all of my meditation techniques. And I required some medical help also, but I eventually had two children. And when they were old enough, I thought, it's time to go back to my spiritual experiences. I couldn't get to them. I couldn't access those dimensions of consciousness. And so I found Stan Grof, and I traveled to hear him speak and experience breath work. And I encountered this incredible man with such an amazing range of knowledge and understanding. And it just spoke to me that if I told his story, I would both evolve my own capacity to experience, to recover my spiritual connection, and share information that might help others.
This is so great. Great story. And I have a question about your film. What is kind of main ideas and main stand kind of manifestations and you wanted to present to people in this film?
I think, you know, Stan, I didn't realize, but in the years since before meeting Stan, I encountered quantum physics and Rupert Sheldrake with morphic resonance and the idea of fractals. And, you know, there have been many opportunities to discover these new ideas that are not really embraced by the scientific community. And so when I heard Stan speak, I realized that, oh, Fritjof Capra was at Esalen, and Michael Harner, who taught shamanic journey work to me, was also Stan's dear friend. So morphic resonance, Rupert Sheldrake presented these ideas and evolved them during his friendship and time at Esalen. So I wanted to include in the movie these ideas because it's context. It helps us understand that we are participating in the universe, that we're part of something bigger, and that we're facing a huge challenge. And humanity, in order to survive what we're the challenge environmentally with climate change, we have COVID-19, we have economic problems, we have to change the way we live on the planet, and we have to find a way through all of this feeling of animosity and aggression between countries. How do we find the way through our challenges and see ourselves as something held in a larger unity and find the connection? And so the movie became an opportunity to share ideas and techniques that might help people come to feeling this within their hearts.
As a film director by myself, I know very well that it's a very hard task to manifest, to express the deep inner life of our psyche, consciousness, the source of our ideas, inspirations, and our life journeys. So I think you had to meet a challenge in language, in cinema tools, in all cinema technologies, trying to express great vastness and depth of STEM discoveries and ideas. Can you share with us your experience?
Well, yes. Yeah. So first of all, I had to personally experience holotropic breathwork numerous times and in numerous settings so that I would have these visions or the ideas that Stan was speaking about, that I would know them, I would have them. And so that I could, from that personal experience, I could try to imagine how I could create something that would speak to audiences. And so one of the things that struck me was how there's a layered nature to these experiences where you're in this reality, it feels so vivid, and then suddenly it's another reality. And it speaks to Stan's coex theory, mm-hmm. the idea of profound emotional core experiences that have layers, and that things happen in our lives to sort of come back around to that. And one of the examples we use in the movie is choking, that perhaps in the process of birth, there's the cord around the baby's neck, and then later there's a sibling that's choking us, or maybe we had a near drowning experience. And so the idea that I wanted visually to show how one moment can lead to another moment, and there's a fluidity. And so I used the technique of layering imagery and dissolving in and out of it, and then found music that allowed an individual to have their own experience that didn't kind of push them into an emotional response. It was neutral but inviting, and the composer did a lovely job with that. So that was one approach to it. And then of course, in telling Stan's story, I could see there were many parallels in my own life, and it felt that if I incorporated some of my story into the movie, it would help the viewers see themselves in the story.
Yeah, this is very important. And I think that working on such a great project like the way of the psychonaut is not only challenging, but also very, very kind of supporting and evolving, since you are kind of together with Stan as creator and doors of his ideas to humanity. I remember very well many Stan visits and seminars in Russia. I also organized them, and I published almost all Stan books in Russia. And now preparing the Way of Psychonaut book to publication. And so I can imagine how many kind of ideas came to your to your mind and how many skills you got from working on these projects?
Well, it's so true. I mean, probably the strongest story is that in the course of making the movie, I had an experience that was of my father dying in a non-ordinary state of consciousness. I witnessed my father dying about a month and a half before he actually did. And it allowed me to process that deep, deep sadness and understand this fear and pain of separation that drives alcoholism and drug addiction and suicide and deep depression. And it really helped me understand that. And then, you know, I was able after that experience, and also in speaking with Stan and sharing the story with him and reading material that he shared with me, I was able to integrate it and understand it, so that when my father was actually dying, I was able to help him and be there for him in a way that I would not have otherwise. And then even now, so much of what we're going through in the world, having worked with Stan and interacting with him, I'm able to perceive what we consider challenges as opportunities. And I'm able to see this process that the whole humanity is being forced to deal with as an invitation for growth. Yeah. And so instead of feeling depressed and hopeless, I'm able to see it as, you know, a new opportunity. And it makes me hopeful. I feel good about the future.
Susan, in a couple of minutes, we will start screening your film to Russian watchers first time. And so what is your advice to people who will start watch it? What is the kind of attitudes or how to tune yourself to get the most of the film?
I would just say relax and allow yourself to feel. I tried to create something that would draw the viewer in, that would invite them to participate. And so I would just say, if feelings come up, if memories come up, and they may come up later, that you just embrace them, because that was the point. It was to try to make a movie that not just tells Stan's story and shares his insights and introduces people to the tools that he offers, but to perhaps draw the viewer into a journey that might encourage them to continue when the movie's over.
Thank you for this advice. It's great. And want to say that everybody who wants to watch this film again can get this film from the website of the Way of Psychonaut and from Susan website. We will have links in our program. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
The watch the film.